very, very much the people of Kingston. Amar Dutwara. You know, I would have spoken in Acholi today, but allow me, first of all, to salute one gentleman in our midst here. I have told you in the past that I am here to represent change. And one of my biggest jobs is to unite the people of Uganda. To unite the people of Uganda from different tribes, from different religions, and from different political parties. So allow me to help me translate. Allow me to invite my brother, the Honorable Time Olanya Olenga. Today we are here not to represent ourselves alone. He is not only representing Olanya Olenga Jimmy.
And by representing Ankena Kena, Pachumpi Ankena Kena.
I am not only representing Chagulanyi Sentamu Bobby Wine.
And Fetie Kachumpi Chagulanyi.
We are representing the people of Uganda.
Wachumpi Chagulanyi Uganda.
I am the leader of the National Unity Platform.
And Latitme Pati Enuni.
And my brother is from the Uganda People's Congress,
UPC.
But we are here standing on the same platform together. Because the future of our country is bigger than our parties. We are here on a mission. The mission is to liberate the people of Uganda. I'm sure many of you have seen me on social media dressed like this yesterday. And many of you know that I did not get the chance to change clothes or even bathe or even eat food. Because we were arrested and kept on a roadblock for the whole day and the whole night. And the mission of the police was to stop us from talking to the people of Uganda, especially the people of Kingston. The second time that I am coming to Kitgum in this campaign trail. The last time I came to Kitgum, I was not allowed to talk to you. Not because what I was talking was about lying to you. Not because it was obscene or vulgar. But because it was the truth. And the Museveni dictatorship fears the truth. But I want to thank God that with this mercy we are able to talk to you today. I know many of you have been intimidated, and those that were able to come here are the heroes, the ones that are not cowards.
poluke kuruje kuno vino kanya ene wona chinyute twale.
And because we have to travel all the way to Kalenga, very many hours away from now. I want this message to be very, very brief. First of all, some people have wondered why I go around the country endorsing people from different political parties. I go around endorsing people from different political parties. It is because I believe that we can only go to a new Uganda if we are united. So before I even go any further, I want to ask the people of Chitgum to vote for this brother of mine by the name of Olanya Olenge. Not because he is going to support my party, but he will support the ideas of the people of Uganda.
Yes, Uganda.
And because we know that we as leaders are supposed to be servants, I want him to undertake before you that he will be your servant and not your boss. So, honorable, you can undertake before the people that you're going to be a servant and not a boss. And that everything they do is what you, everything they tell you is what you're going to represent because they're the ones sending you there. And before I forget, I also want to tell you that I am running for president. I am not here because I am a professor or a military general. But because I'm here to represent the common person, to represent the poor people, to represent the ghetto people, to represent the border riders, to represent the unemployed young people, to represent the young people of this country. And I've said this before and I want to say it before you, the people of Chitgum, that if you vote for me, you will be getting a servant and not a boss. Many of you have been wondering why I put on a bulletproof when I'm a presidential candidate. But that should show you the kind of dictatorship that you are dealing with. In 1980, before many of us were born, Museveni took guns and went to the bush because he was claiming that they had rigged the election. And the President Museveni every now and then he talks evil things about President Milton Obote. But I want to remind you that during the 1980 election when President Milton Obote was president, there was no tear gas.
No tear gas,
when Milton Obote was president, no presidential candidate had to put on a bulletproof.
Presidential candidate, ma open okero, ma bawor chat.
When Milton Obote was president,
karmu borno chip president.
All those hospitals had medicines.
Or yar weng no tiki yen yeriye.
And the schools were working.
School weng no tika tik mape.
And Museveni did not even get 1% of the vote.
Museveni pon no wa vote a chile kembene.
But all of you are seeing me as a presidential candidate, but very dirty like this.
Presidential candidate.
It is because the roads that are going all over northern Uganda are look like roads that are not
Nipadu.
I am coming from Lamor district. But I saw that in the whole district, not even a single first grade comes in P7 and senior
4.
When you look at the schools and the health centers in those districts, and indeed the whole Uganda, you wonder what has been happening for 35 years. My brothers and sisters, for 35 years, we have been made slaves in our country.
We are one of the people.
I said we've been made slaves in our own country. And let me explain this to you.
Where are you, Matuti?
Please pay attention so that you can understand. Because the sad thing is that many of our people don't know that they are actually slaves in their country. The biggest problem that Museveni caused to us is that he attacked our minds first, and he blinded most of the eyes of the people. And that's why he does not want us to talk to you or even talk on radio. Because when we talk to you, your eyes will open. Have you ever seen a presidential election where a candidate is not allowed to talk on radio? Where a candidate is not allowed to use the main roads? One man called Steve Biko said that the most potent weapon in the hands of the oppressor,
the weapon,
the most powerful weapon, in the hands of the oppressor is the mind of the oppressed. And if you can free your mind, and I am requesting that you listen to this. Because we went through all the tear gas and the bullets to make sure we talk to you and you listen. What I am going to tell you today, you will not hear it on radio. And you will not hear it on TV. And some politician will not tell you this. Because anybody that dares to say this ends up either dead or in prison. But because me, I am not scared of Museveni, I will say this. So listen to this. I was telling you that unfortunately so many of our people don't know that they are slaves. The elders that are here present know exactly what I'm talking about. But sadly, many of you are very young. Although you are not too young to change your destiny. The way Museveni is operating, he is operating like in the days of apartheid. And in the days of colonialism, and in the days of slavery, somebody there don't disorganize the people, the president is talking to them. Yeah, hear me now. Make sure that the people them hear what me talk about. Yeah, hear me. Wagwan. Museveni wanted to make you his slaves. He picks one person among you and he gives that one person so much money and he gives that person so much power and he will use that person to make the rest of you slaves. And because that person is one of you, that person is going to blind you and lie to you. Now let me tell you this.
Where are you going?
I said, let me tell you this.
Yeah, we know where are you going?
There was a lady here in Kitukum. Listen to me and listen very carefully. Listen to me and listen very carefully. There was a lady here in Kitukum that many of us used to look up to when we are young boys. She used to say the truth. She used to speak truth to power. She used to protect the environment. She used to represent the people. But once upon a time, she was given so much money. And because I told you that we have to travel to Karenga, allow me to give you this information. And I am asking you, whoever is here, please make sure everybody knows about this. Now, like I told you, that Museveni is operating like colonialists. When colonialists wanted to take the land of African people, they chose the few greedy ones. And they gave them so much land. And they used them to enslave all of us. Until one day, God decided to answer our prayers. So, Museveni came here in Kitukum.
Museveni been in Kitukum
and he used a lot of money and bought somebody who was telling the truth. Then overnight, he sold all the dreams of our people. Do you know a forest called Maria? In Buganda where I come from, we named Beatrice Anywa Mama Maria.
No, Beatrice Anywa Mama Maria.
Because she used to say the truth. Because she used to stand for the truth. But because of the corruption of Museveni, you know what happened. So I am telling you, brothers and sisters, that your future is in your hands. I say your future is in your hands. Every 5 years, the people of Uganda get the power back. And they have the right to choose the leader who they want to trust that power with. Museveni has betrayed us so many times. Museveni's people have betrayed us so many times. But because Rubang is very powerful, we have this opportunity. My brothers and sisters, I may say all these things. We may promise you good schools. We may promise you good hospitals. We can promise you good roads. But the power is in your hands. You have the power to change all this. Let me see your hand if you are a voter. Now, do you see those hands that you put up? Those hands are more powerful than guns. Only if you decide to use them well. If you decide to use them well. With that vote that you have, you can change the destiny of Uganda. You can change the destiny of Uganda. The last time I was here, I was a musician. That brother of mine called Obama, we grew up in the same ghetto in Kamocha. His brother Lapeja was my manager. But it is you, the common people, that got me from the ghetto until here where I am. So I want you to believe that we can change our destiny. And we can have a Uganda that we all believe in. In a Uganda where NUP and UPC can stand together. In
Uganda where NUP and UPC can stand together.
Where nobody is going to tear gas the other. Where the police is not going to be killing people but protecting them and their property. Right now we are fighting the coronavirus pandemic. We are fighting a disease. But do you ever ask yourself a question? Why we have more police patrol cars than ambulances? If we had good leadership in Uganda, the salary of all medical workers would have gone up. If we had good leadership in Uganda, we would be buying more drugs in hospitals than
colleges.
We would be having more drugs than tear gas. But what is happening in our country? I can go on and on and on about our problem. But I've already told you, my brothers and sisters, that you are the solution. You are the solution. You can build a Uganda. Where Olanya Olenge and Joel Senyonyi will be in parliament. And they will only be arguing about what will make Uganda better. But we have had one dictator for 35 years. A dictator that has gone on to compromise all those that have tried to oppose him. Who has gone on to kill people with impunity until God went to the ghetto and brought this bad boy from Kamocha. So when you go to the polls, brothers and sisters, I want you to think about the elders, our grandmothers and fathers, our fathers and mothers that have had dreams, which dreams were betrayed. I want you to think about yourself, especially you, the young people, who are the majority of our population. I want you to remember that the future of Uganda is in our hands. I want you to think about our little children, the young boys and girls, who cannot vote, but they know they want a Uganda. In a Uganda where to become a minister. minister, it does not depend on your tribe.
Uganda minister,
where to get a government scholarship, it does not depend on who knows you. A Uganda that offers equal opportunity for
everyone.
That is a new Uganda,
and Uganda,
and that is our promise to you. So finally, as I conclude, I want to ask all of you to make sure that you all come out and vote on the 14th of January. Come out in large numbers and vote. Please don't say we are too many, even if me I don't vote. We need every vote. We want to win every polling station. We want to win every constituency. We want to win every district. We want to win with 90%. We want to have our people represented. When you go to the ballot paper, you're not going to find the name Bobby Wine. You will find Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert. And you will see the symbol of this umbrella. And when you go to vote for my brother Olenge,
if you are going,
you are going to find him saluting you.
We know energy saluting him.
Pick him. And all forces of change. We are not here to divide the opposition. We are here to unite and kick out a dictator. We are removing a dictator. So make sure you become our agents of change. I've said this before and I'm saying it again, that I am not any different from you. What I am doing, you can do too. So I'm asking all of you to become Bobby Wines. Wherever you are, let the message flow non-stop. For seven cannot manage our generation. We are a smart generation. We are going to remove him from power. And if he tries to kill our people like he did in the past weeks, he will end up like his friend Gaddafi. He will end up like his friend Mugabe. If he tries to kill our people like he has been doing, he will end up like his friend Omar el-Bashir. The money that the military is using to kill our people is donated to us from the United States of America. Every year, Uganda gets more than $100 million from America. I am already talking to the government of America. So don't be scared. And all these patrolers, all the security that you see moving and following me should not worry you. They are following me because I am already president. All you have to do is come out in large numbers and vote. And our lives will never be the same again. Our roads will never be the same again. Our schools will never be the same again. Hospitals will never be the same again. I thank you for listening to me, ladies and gentlemen. I thank you very much. Now before I go, allow me to name for you some of our candidates also.
We have
a brother called Thabo Mbeki. Kindly send him to be the counselor for LC3. We have a brother called Thabo Peter Paul. We have a brother called Noom Simon Peter. Make him our mayor for Kitgum. So that when I come back as the new president, we will all be enjoying Kitgum with
one way we can have.
Thank you very much.
Sorry, madam.
For God and my country.
Before I go,
do you want to hear the voice of my brother? Do you want to see my Nubian brother? Come in, Nubian.
Power.